Farmty, I'm Mark with today with Project Hospital. I'm doing this series because this game does remind me a little bit of Prison Architect. But what I will be doing in this first episode is probably at least one and two, maybe even three of the tutorials. And then maybe the campaign as well. So, learn the basics of diagnosing and treating patients. Let's go. Also have to probably, let me check. So I guess the sound is a little bit too high, judging by it. So I'm just lowering it down a little bit. So what I know of this game is that you have to run a hospital and build it like you do in Prison Architect and all that. Hi boss, thank you for coming back to help us. We know that you had your reasons for retirement, but we can really use someone with your talents. Know you were good at diagnosing patients. Next. We're having some staff issues at the clinic. Could you help us out with a few patients? Don't worry, I'll remind you how everything works here. First, let's have a closer look to see what's going on. You can zoom in out with the mouse wheel and pen by holding. Okay. Change the view to your liking. So, it was. Excellent. Now select the patient who's been patiently waiting for us in the doctor's office. So, I'm guessing this. Patient card will give you all the important information and you can control what happens with your patients from here. On the right side, you will find the history of the last 8 selected characters. If you click the portrait of any character, the camera will center on them. Oh, that's nice. You choose who is responsible for your patient. Either you let your staff take care of them, or you can take over directly. Let's keep this patient under your control. A part of the card shows you, so you can even do it automatically, like with AI. So it's prints it automatic. That's nice. And the upper part of the card shows you the patient's personal data and department assignments. The needs panel on the right shows the satisfaction level, and you can see characters' perks and quirks below that. Okay, it's a little bit restroom, hunger, discomfort, satisfaction. Aha. The next panel shows all possible diagnoses that match patients' known symptoms, or from the most likely ones. Selecting a diagnosis will set it as the final one. Aha! Symptom panel shows all revealed and hidden symptoms. On the left you can see the doctor the patient is currently assigned to. Yeah, we have just one doctor. What I know of, there is also room to expand, because this area is still, where my mouse is still empty. Guessing we will have to also do that in the tutorial. This is an examination panel where you can order examinations to reveal what the hidden symptoms are. Try to select skin allergies test to reveal enough hidden symptoms so there's only one possible diagnosis left. So yeah, this will take a little while, I guess. Hope there's also a button that you can speed this up. I'm also going to look a little bit around. This is an ambulance, toilets, a reception seems, yeah, and just the normal space where the doctor is. Oh yeah, and of course a little bit of food, not much, like a restaurant or something, but good enough for a clinic. So yeah, it seems like That the AI can also do this all. Procedures have finished. Scheduled procedures have finished. Last skin allergy test. Patient is waiting for you to plan another examination or select a diagnosis. Hay fever. I'll go ahead and select all the diagnosis that left. Yes, this one. For treating the patient. Hover over the icon of your select. Okay, go ahead and choose the treatment. Yes. Oh, you can even test which one it could be. Treating drugs. Suppose maybe this one. Good job. You treated your first patient. Depending on the selected treatment, your patient will be either cured or might return later with new symptoms. I mean, hay fever is difficult to cure, so. But I know of it, at least. If you have medicines, then it can help to stop it, but I don't know if it's curable. Okay. Let's move on to help another patient. Here's our next patient. Click the patient that is sitting at the doctor's office. Probably noticed earlier that some examinations are not available. They need special rooms or equipment. Oh, they are great. Aha. Your mouse of the great tooltip will tell you what is missing. In this case, we are missing both the room and the technologist to be able to run the x-ray. So I'm guessing this one. For the scoliosis. The tooltips are available throughout the game with extra information for every icon in every category. Ha. Huh. Oh no, wait. Yep. Not here, but here. Okay. Good to know. So for now, let us fix the hospital real quick. Oh, well, it just got made on its own. Okay, that's also good. I suppose I will be able to build it later on, I guess. Open the patient card. You can select the now available examination. There we go. Want to keep the captive in the loop, you must keep the patient under your care as or as monitored. Same icon switches between as all modes. Okay. So under your care, just as we need. Card can be closed by the X in the recording. Don't forget you can always access the last few characters from the list on the right side. Take some time. Yay! Speed. Pop-up notification inform you that the x-ray has revealed a symptom. Scoliotic findings. How you want to receive notification by switching into the pop-up or log in the lower left corner of the message window. Okay, right here or what? Ah. From the log panel on the bottom right. Ah, oh, like this. Reveal the last hidden symptom unique to the patient's disease. If the diagnosis was not clear, this would confirm it with 100% probability. Treat 4 patients. Oh, it's too fast! Okay. Controlled by doctors, yeah. So that is rather neat. So the doctors will do it on its own. Like I have to order them to walk to the table. Achievement unlocked. Young doctor. Hey. That's pretty good. So this is still the last notification that I got. So no one seems to be able to go in there because they don't know the diagnosis yet. Makes sense. And I'm getting money. Awesome, you've done it. Let's pause it real quick. Thank you for your help. And I also got the intern achievement. You can take over from here. I think you are needed elsewhere. Click next to continue. Nice. Oh, that was rather easy. Discover a different aspect of construction. Hey, by building a small functional clinic. Here we go. Hi, boss. We also know that diagnosing was not the only thing that you did. You also were good at building hospitals. Am I? Let's welcome to this nice property we recently acquired. So let's refresh a bit on how to build and equip your very own hospital and what options there are. Aha. Let's switch to build mode. It's laying down foundations. The foundation tool was selected already. Cover, for example, 20 by 20 tiles. That's a big space. Okay, how do I move the camera? There we go. Excellent. Now here's a quick summary of what's available to build. Fine, main categories: foundations, constructions, doors and windows, options and prefabs. There. Okay. Rooms are divided between mandatory red number, green number, some rooms are shared between departments. Space, one of each, a doctor's office, a waiting room, and a restroom. These are needed for a working clinic. So let's get the... Okay, let's think for a minute. We need a waiting room, and let's get a waiting room. Let's get it like this. Waiting room. Achievement builder. So we have a waiting room. Let's get a... no, can I delete this? Is this possible? There we go. Achievement destroy. Okay, I want it to be... real nice. So I'm guessing I want the entrance to be here, something like right around this corner. So we will have a reception here. So like this, then we have a little bit of a reception area, and maybe also even a little pathway to go up towards this room, which will be the doctor's office. Oh no, the doctor's office I will be putting down here. And the restroom I will put right next to it. Well done, with the floor plan done, let's build some walls. You can find them in the building mode and construction gallery. Ah, right there. White wall. You shall not pass, achievement unlocked. Nice. So I'm guessing I want to block this off for now. Also, close this in, of course. Don't forget to place doors. Yeah, that's maybe a good idea. So like right around here. Which one do I need for bathroom door? Is there something like that? think I just need a normal door, I guess. Oh no, here it was one. I don't know how the door is levitating, but that might just be me. Ah, can't get it in the middle. Jeez. Nah, but I will leave it like this. So let's get just a normal door in. The restroom doesn't have to be all closed up, so. But we have a big room still available. Get also some big windows in. So of course not get any not any windows in the bathroom, because that would be odd. Okay, so we have a few doors. Doors right here. They can go to the restroom, they can go to the this room and this room. Simply click on the floor of any of the rooms. It's either mandatory or recommended for the room. So what is needed? Missing staff, missing equipment. Just checking what I can. How do I rotate? Oh, R. So I guess a table right here. Ah, that's the spot. Achievement. Jeez, I'm getting a lot of achievements now. So let's get this in. Let's also get a tool in to let them sit on. I mean, that's rather trash, so maybe I can delete this, yes. Okay, what do we also need? Equipment table. Is this something? Yeah, maybe an equipment cabinet might also be good. I'm just using it so that there's a lot in this. Okay, am I missing something? Both can be needed in here as well. I don't know, it's saying that there's still some stuff left that I'm missing. One doctor. Yeah. But I don't know what the hell I'm doing. Maybe a PC? No, I was not thinking about that. A PC. I mean, we have a lot of money, so why not? paper holder. Maybe also a printer. Could be done here. Scrubbing sink, yeah, sure. Okay, I do not have any room for that, so I might need another table. A square table right in the corner. For the audio meter. There we go. That's everything that is needed in this room. That's a lot, but it's doable. Okay, so what does the rest... No, I thought the... Oh. Get out of here. Okay. We need a wall between it. Oh, we're gonna get three toilets. Hey, that's better. Can do is make a door. Not a door with a window. Oh wait, I need a wall, of course, to block this in. There we go, that's better. In that case, I can get a few windows in. In that case. Do we need something else? Maybe a sink, yeah. Hand dryer, yeah. Okay, that's that. This all in. Get also a few televisions in. And what shall we do? Maybe the benches? Oh, cue machine, yeah. There you go. Do you need to connect them? How does that work? Human machines work together with one or more info TVs. When removed, this system provides smoother patient flow to adjacent rooms. That's really neat. I mean, does that mean that we have to get three? I don't think so. I think just one is good enough. I mean, it's just a clinic. Okay, what do we need? We will hire one with help from our game tutorial. Oh, here. Hire new staff. Management mode. Click on workspace in your chosen room. Left side for day shift, right side for night shift. Day shift. Oh, so we can even get a night shift, haha. Two hidden perks. Hard worker. That sounds neat. You are hired. You have more departments, you can switch between them using the icons on the main panel. Select radiology department and open management mode again. How? Okay, so it will start. That's neat. What is the doctor doing back there? Can I move you? You're behind the desk. God damn it. Hold on. Ah, let's just keep it like that, I guess. But just move it around a bit. So there's more room. I have more other parts, you can switch between them using the icons on the main panel, sir. Check of rules, we need to have a functional radiology department. Build equipment, staff them. Oh, so we need that as well. Oh, the waiting room we already have, so we need an x-ray room. And another waiting room? We have a waiting room. Can we use the same waiting room for that? I mean, it works. How big is this area? This is 5x7. I was not expecting this to be H. So I guess I will have a little bit of a hallway here as well. Oh. There we go. Okay. I also need to fix this door. Because I got the wrong door. I think I need this door. That's way better. Okay, I need a few windows. Like two. It's a possibility. And what do they need? That's a big machine. Equip my cabinets. Okay, we need a table. Office desk or something. There we go. We need an X-ray viewer. No, I need not two, but just one. Oh yeah, now we need a staff. Suppose this one will do. Finish the last objectives. Treat 6 patients. Oh. So they need another waiting room. Okay. Not expecting that. So now we need to fix this again. We need some stuff. Okay, I think that's fixed. Yay, they're coming in. Oh, I don't have enough chairs. Let me fix that real quick. There we go, that might be better. Yay! Love how I put the chair down, but they don't even want to sit on it. Well, maybe leave it like this. I can't sell this, I guess. And let's go. Maybe they did need a tool. I don't know, I'm just figuring stuff out now, so no, I'm just not gonna try it anymore. No, stop. I need to stop. Before we finish, let's have a look at the last category and great time saving prefabs. Oh, that's neat. Yeah, reception. I mean, it can fit in here. Or here. This is a big boy. What do I think of reception? Does it have to be surrounded? Why not? Why doesn't he want to do this? I don't know. Okay. Resident achievement unlocked. Okay. So this has been a little bit of a longer episode. I mean, it's 40 minutes, holy fuck. But anyways, we have done these two tutorials, so that's at least something. I know at least a little bit better how to manage this game. Of course, not as perfect as some people, but anyways, I will leave this episode right here. So please leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and see you next video. Bye.